Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Hola a todos. It's Finnish Duende here. And yes, I finally have a new camera and a new microphone as well. And you are watching the first episode of a series called Paso a Paso, a tutorial for Entre Dos Aguas by Paco de Lucía. But before we start, I would like to seize this opportunity to thank you all, especially the subscribers and all the comments and everything. It really means a lot to me, and it feels good to read them. Thank you. All right, so I'm just gonna explain quickly how the tutorial works. I'm gonna cut the whole song into little pieces, and each piece will be an episode of this series, and we'll go through that segment, a little segment of the song, first with the metronome 2 times, first 76 beats per minute, so quite slowly, and the second time 138 beats per minute, so you can see the structure a little bit better. And the third time I'll play with the backing track as well. And I'll also provide additional tips to practice efficiently, and especially the first episode, this episode, will have most of those things to get you started with. So, without further ado, let's get started. All right, guys, so I'll explain first the chord sections, or the chord progressions in the song. So, there's basically three phases or segments, or how do you call them? But, three different rotations in the song, and the first one goes like this. There's three chords used, and of course you count to four, like 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3, and it's a basic rhythm, rumba rhythm. And the chords are A minor 7. I'll try to show it a little bit closer. B minor 7, I believe. And then back to A minor 7. And this is something of a B7. I'm not exactly sure. I have to put them in the description. And then how the rotation goes. There's just you count two rotations of fours with each chord. So basically, if you simplify things, it's like this. And then I can demonstrate a little bit how it would sound if you would use a little bit more advanced strumming techniques. Basically E minor, and then D major, and then C7, and then back to this chord we used just a little while ago. So that would be third section, or the last section. There's only two chords, and it's only E minor and E major. And that's it for the chords, at least. So now we can move on to the solo section. Alright, so you count to four. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the playing starts after four, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And so forth. And now we go over this section slowly. 76 beats per minute. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here this section ends with an index finger, and then you can memorize it like this. Try to show it closer. We can go over the chords as well. Solo section a little bit faster. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright guys, so there's basically two spots in the song that have insanely fast piccato passages going on. So a good way to learn them is to start making repeats of those particular spots on the song from the very start. Just do them really slowly with a really slow beats per minute, but I'll show you here how they go. So the first one, you might want to rememberize this. You start with an index finger on the second string. So thank you. So, this is the first one to rememberize. And then, the second one, it's the same start, but it goes a little bit further, so. And a little bit slower. And then, later in the song, there is also two spots like this. Here's the chord. Let's take it again. Second one. Wait, sorry. If you recognize the spot, so, to sum it all up, you have to rememberize this. And so those are basically the parts that are the fastest pegato parts of the song. I'll demonstrate with the metronome.